We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
Among the oldest questions that we humans have asked ourselves are, who are we? What are we doing here? Where did we come from? How did we get here? And where are we going? Two of these questions are now approachable in a scientific manner, that is, where did we come from and how did we get here? And these two terms apply to the term anthropogeny. I explain the origin of humans. The key word in CARTA's name is anthropogeny, the scientific quest to explain the origin of humans. It lies at the intersection of humanities and natural sciences, and I believe that the only way to address these two questions is to draw evidence from these very different disciplines. This symposium is brought to you by CARTA, the Center for Academic Research and Training Anthropogeny. It's a transdisciplinary collaboration between faculty at UC San Diego and the Salk Institute, along with interested scientists at other institutions all across the world, whose mission is to explore and explain the origins of human phenomena. CARTA is co-directed by Fred Gage, Margaret Schoninger, and myself, with Pascal Gagneau as associate director. We'd like to thank our major sponsors and benefactors and patrons are listed here, and we see in the rotating slides if they come up. We present this with gratitude to CARTA's founding sponsor, the Mathers Foundation, New York. Closed captioning for the recording of the symposium is made possible by CARTA patrons, Ingrid Benishka Perkins and Gordon Perkins, increasing the access and reach of CARTA's free live stream symposia. Additional support for this symposium came from CARTA friend Catherine Furr and CARTA supporter John Sterling. As you enjoy today's presentation, we invite you to consider what contribution you or your organization might make to expand our understanding of the human journey. Email or follow this link to learn more about how to become an individual CARTA supporter or a CARTA corporate sponsor today. Special thanks are due to the CARTA staff, Lindsay, Kate, Vishu, Linda Nelson, and Jesse Roby for their wonderful attempts to make this all work. And of course, UCTV for producing the videos from this program. And thanks to you as well, our viewers. Through your interest and dedicated efforts of CARTA and the contributing partners, CARTA Symposium has become the number one science program aired by UCTV, amassing over 40 million views by the end of 2021. We invite you to explore the entire CARTA video library prepared by UCTV for free at the link shown below. On behalf of CARTA, I welcome you to this anthropogeny presentation on humans, the planet-altering apes, co-chaired by myself and Margaret Schoninger. Thank you, and I sincerely hope you enjoyed this symposium. From their inception, we have made sure that CARTA Symposia emphasize our primary objectives to explore and explain where we come from and how we got here. To ensure this focus on human origins, we have generally limited discussions of current day implications and questions regarding the future of humanity, such as where are we going. However, we now feel an urgent moral and practical imperative to call attention to the long and short-term impact of humans on the planet that we inhabit, and the consequences for the immediate future of our species. As a first step in the direction, our March symposium was on human origins and humanity's future, which introduced discussion of the current age of human activity in the term Anthropocene. In selecting topics for today, we decided not to focus on the now familiar impacts of humans on risks of global climate disruption, excessive population growth, and pandemic infectious disease. Beyond these well-known impacts, it is very easy, sadly very easy, to collect a long and still incomplete list of additional topics, ranging from indoor air pollution, plastic waste accumulation, earth movement triggered by human activity, all the way to the modern scourge of excessive paperwork, regulation, and bureaucracy. The time available only allows us to address 10 topics shown on this slide, which include the 6 mass extinction of species, spread of invasive species, loss of biodiversity, large-scale ecosystem damage, freshwater scarcity, modification of planet microbiome, human domination of global nitrogen cycle, feeding 10 billion people, chemical pollutants and fertility, and space debris and the Kessler syndrome. As you may have noticed, the chosen topics largely focus on negative impacts, which, sad to say, also happen to characterize a great majority of issues at hand. Over the next few hours, you're likely to feel more and more depressed as we lay bare some of these challenging impacts of humans. But the humans are also capable of dark humor, such as this planet doctor who assures us that the bad news is you've got advanced stage humans. The good news is they're just about run their course and you should be on the mend soon. But we're also capable of remarkable capacity for reality denial. As Calvin says to Hobbes, it's not denial. I'm just very selective about the reality I accept. And this reality denial allows us to exist in mental states ranging from extreme optimism bias to hopeless depressive realism. Now, it is very hard for a single human mind to simultaneously hold these two states. But maybe as a collective, we can hope for the best while preparing for the worst.